guys. So this is what I'm doing today. I am doing some painting, and something that you guys might not know about me, but I like to paint and do artsy crafty things. So yeah, I'm just going to show you. I have this canvas so far. It's in no way done, but this is just the base purple coat. It's showing up really blue on camera, but it's not. I mixed this blue color, just an acrylic blue color, with this little one. I really like the Martha Stewart Crafts paints. Those are really good. And I think I mixed in a little bit of white, and I got this kind of nice purple color. It's showing up real blue, I don't know why. And then I mixed this metallic-y gold color, which is really cool, with some white, and that's going to go on, if it'll focus, the outside here. And just so that this will be even, I made a stencil. I'm going to cut this out so that I can put it on the other side so that it's perfect, like, mirror image. And there is going to be a little monogram to go in my bathroom. I'm going to show you the two well, actually, you've probably seen them already in my videos, but I'll show you again. This is a painting that I most recently did, and if you'll see, I like to do this sort of watercolory kind of effect and make it look just more, not like one solid color, and I really never like to put just one solid color, like, straight from the tube out onto the base of the canvas, because I think it just adds a lot more dimension and, I guess, character to it if it's diluted slightly or changed in some way. Sorry, a UPS person came while I was filming that, but yeah, I like to add a little bit of white in or play with the amount of water that's on my brush and just kind of get a cool effect like that. I think you can see that a little bit better now. So yeah, this isn't done. It's going to be a lot more purple, but this is just sort of a base thing. I like to work in layers as opposed to just doing, like, bam, just like putting a straight up purple color all over the canvas. I like there to be a little bit of differentiation, especially when it's just something like a quote, like I'm putting this on this canvas. So yeah, that's what we have going on. Okay, so it only took me like 3 hours, but this is what the canvas looks like. It's showing up darker on camera. I had to lighten it a whole lot. So I took like a lavender color and just like washed it over. I did some finger painting and it was really intense. Maybe I should have filmed that, but I didn't have anyone to film me while I was doing it, and it required both hands. So yeah, I basically will take like a smaller paintbrush like this one, and I'll like put a line of paint and then I blend it out with a sponge brush. So that's how I get this sort of cool like watercolory thing going on, where it's sort of streaky but like in a cool way. I don't know, I'm thinking of adding a little bit more color to it, because I did do like sort of a whitewash to lighten it, but I don't want to mess up the color now, so I am just very conflicted. So yeah, this is where we are with that. Where's the, okay. And then this is going in my bathroom. I'm going to put a monogram there, and that's going to be outlined in black. It matches my bathroom like perfectly, so I'm happy about that, because I have a wall in there that doesn't have anything on it, so yeah. Alright, hi guys! I realize that I haven't had my face on camera all day, but I don't have any makeup on. Last night, I blow-dried my hair, and then I put it into braids, and it made like these nice sort of waves, and I think this would look really pretty even if I just took a few pieces and curled them. It's like never worked for me before, but I think that's because I put my wet hair in a braid overnight. But now it's just more of a subtle wave instead of having like that weird like 90s crimped look, which is not my favorite look or something that I would want to rock in public or anything. So I'll have to remember this, because sometimes I am just too lazy to curl all of my hair, and I get halfway through and I'm like, why did I start this? Now I have to finish it, otherwise it's gonna look really strange having half my hair curled and half of it like my natural, which is like pretty much straight, and I just got a text. But yeah, I'm just going to show you. I have my two canvases laid out here. I drew on my monogram. That's what it looks like. And I think I'm going to have to move the L over this way and the M. I have to redraw that before I paint that in. But this is what we have going for us. I might outline this in glitter or something. I want to make it look pretty. So yeah, that's that. And then this is the final canvas, and I am pretty happy with it. It's not perfect, and it was definitely a process because, like I mentioned earlier, I do not like to use just one purple color out of, or whatever color it might be, out of the tube. I like to mix my own colors, so that just makes it harder when you're trying to layer and get the right color, and then once you do find the right color, it is almost impossible to recreate it, which is both really unique and interesting, but also kind of difficult. Plus, I had difficulties because you can hardly see the pencil on here. I have marked out, I did that before I even painted. I marked off the like margin spaces here at the top, and then like how much for each line of writing I want to give, but then it was just hard to write on there, and it's not really showing up well, so hopefully tomorrow when I go back over it with pencil, it'll show up better. I'm going to use like a regular pencil, not a mechanical one this time, I think. That might help. Let's hope. But yeah, this is just the progress on both of them, and I'm excited to update you guys on those tomorrow. So yeah, I think I'm going to end the vlog here. And what am I doing tomorrow? I don't think I'm doing anything tomorrow, so I'll just update you on that and whatever else I happen to be doing. Have a fabulous day, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye! I haven't said that in a while. But yeah, bye!